Hello, all you lovely freedom people out there, and welcome to today's Fireside Freedom Chat. I'm your host, Bradley Freedom. Today's guest is Dr. Tommy John. That's right. Definitely one of my most exciting conversations to date at the Freedom People Podcast. And overall, 2020 has really given us a whole new direction and inspiration in life. Now, if you do not know who Dr. Tommy John is, well, sit back, relax, and listen to this because you're going to get to know him real quick. Before we get into this amazing conversation, I'm going to need you to grab your phone, take those two little thumbs you got there, and type in this, Tommy and the number one, Tommy and the number one, and you're going to send that to 844-992-3733. That's 844-992-3733, the word Tommy and the number one. We're going to send you out today's show notes. Also, head on over to thefreedompeople.org. Sign up with us. This is going to be epic. Come on, let's go.
What's up?
What's up, bro? Fucking sick. Dude, I am doing fabulous, dude. 420 at 420. What's up?
That's great. Sorry, I messed up on the... did you get my email about 5?
Yeah, dude, that's cool, man, dude.
My bad.
Dude, it's all good. No, if you don't mind, I'm going to record it.
It's usually 5:30, and I totally jacked it up. So, and it's kind of an important... Well, it's all guests are important, but this guy's hard to get. And I... Yeah. So,
dude, sorry, dude, don't sweat it at all. I'm just honored we're doing this at all, bro. It's
I appreciate it.
Yeah, man. Well, you know you're a fucking rock star in this world, dude.
And I try to keep myself humble, but I love that. I will write that down somewhere.
Yeah, put that down
for when people try to take me down. So we're good. Appreciate you, man.
Nah, appreciate you, bro. Thank you, thank you. GoFin, could you shut down the music real quick? Thank you. So what's going on, dude? That's cool that you're even here. It was such a, like, a big old swing, you know, for the fences. Hey, you know, well, you know what I mean to me? I'm just going on Telegram, so I don't know how much you know about us, but me and my lady friend here, we started thefreedompeople.org, right? And, there's a business directory, and we've got, like, a social media platform. We're also releasing a job board this week.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, freedom-based. I don't know if you know Peggy Hall.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, so we were on her show earlier this month, and we've been working with her since December, kind of back and forth, and she's really pushing what we're doing. And so then also what we did is we started this podcast for education. Just like what you're doing, dude, freedoms are being, not that they haven't been being taken away from us for a very long time, but now...
Right.
Since last year, it's fucking go time, dude. And so we're World War III, man. So we're in.
Dude, I love it. Freedompeople.org.
Yeah, thefreedompeople.org. Yeah.
Thefreedompeople.org.
Yep.
Okay.
Yes,
perfect.
Sir. Yeah. Let's see. What do I got? I got questions. We got a lot of questions here.
Dude, let's do this. I'm an open book. Anything you want.
Where is this thing? Here we go. Yeah, man. That's awesome. Oh, yeah. This is like one of my favorite. How long do you expect? What is your life expectancy for yourself?
And so I picture 108. 108.
108?
Yeah, but it's like a functioning 108, self-reliant, not responsible on anybody. Like I can feel, I can experience this life and I don't know how I go out, but it's going to be a nice, peaceful transition. But 108 and at 100, on my 100th birthday, I'm going to get a jacket that's like a Century Club jacket. That's like, I'm 100. Let's go.
Yeah, like those gold jackets, right? Like, what is that? The Right? What is that? The fucking golf jacket. What is that thing called?
Yeah, the green one. The green one. The gold one was Happy Gilmore.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. I love Happy Gilmore.
I want to start celebrating like functioning at a late age. I told two people in my office today, they're like, we're late 50s. I'm like, you're literally halfway through. Halfway through. And it's like this huge doom and gloom. I'm like, we're designed to go to like 120, 130, 140.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Start taking care and making that your reality. Not that living forever is the goal, but right. Living high, right? Yeah, like, yeah. Why not make that your benchmark and then come off of that? But we don't think that way. So I want to bring back and make like 100, like hot again.
That's just the new
like
black.
Make like walking, like hot. Like yeah. Walking is the shit.
Well, no, dude, I agree with you 1,000%. And I think that we're very limited. And it's just society, how we're raised, everything. Like, look at even retirement. They're like, oh, well, just think your life is going to end, retire around 60. You're going to die. I mean, and we plan our lives around that instead of like, dude, like, I have no fucking idea how old I'm going to live. But to your point, I know that I'm going to live a very full life and I want to be alive. I don't want this fucking, I don't want to be on 50 pills, dude, sitting around pissing myself. Dude, is that living? No, dude, that's existing on some fucked up healthcare system. Excuse me, sick care system that they've got us in. Dude.
I posted not long ago, like, not dead doesn't equal healthy. And that's what we've got now. As long as you're not dead, you're healthy. And it's like, wait, what the hell are you talking about? That couldn't be further from the truth. And so we're just afraid to live because we're afraid to die. It's like, we're all going out of here. Like, what are you talking about?
Yeah, so, dude. Yeah, exactly, man. And that's so funny you say that. My baby mama here, chick Emily, she's the other half that started the Freedom People. But that's one of the first things she said last year. You know, she kind of during this thing, like a lot of people, it woke a lot of people up out of whatever's going on, right?
Oh, yeah.
To a lot of these belief systems that are, you know, core belief systems, I want to say. You know what I mean? Like, the government's telling you the truth, you know? The news is telling you the truth. They're 100% truthful. I mean, you see the new CNN stuff, right? I mean, it's coming out that they're super truthful. Like, But dude, 100%, dude, I was in the Marines. So I was stationed down there at Camp Pendleton, right? And in 1997, I was fucking out there. And I had my awakening, man. I found out CNN was lying to us, dude. And it was like, that's when my whole world just exploded, dude. So,
right.
You know what I mean? It's just, and that, so here we are. And I'm just happy that I'm happy for 2020. Believe it or not, man, it was actually one of the best years of my life by far, dude. Like everything that's come of it, like now I have purpose. I mean, before this, I mean, I love my life. I was having a great life, right? I'm a DJ as well. I'm a musician. So I was out in the clubs fucking DJing, you know, partying, having a great time, dude. You know, I'm a software engineer, you know, I'm an entrepreneur guy. So I'm having a great old time, man. I was having a great time, but I was also kind of, I became complacent, right? Because to be honest, I got tired of trying to convince people that what I was saying wasn't psychotic. You know what I mean? From like 1997 to about, I don't remember, 10 years ago, I was like, well, nothing's going to change. And I remember feeling helpless about a lot of things. And so I just started working on myself, you know, meditation, yoga, all that good jazz. And now we're waking up, bro. So next question, can you talk about your 8 essentials, please?
Oh God. Yeah. Good question. So first of all, I didn't create them. They're not mine, but I've just observed a lot from the people who are doing the real work of putting people into positions to heal the incurables, right? The things that are supposed to be radical and miracles, which are just, it's the default. It's just what the way we are. And then I gathered them from talking to every 90 plus year old who seems to be living a pretty vibrant life. And I ask them like, what's the secret? What do you guys do? What is this? Pulling all this information on everybody that chooses to heal, who wants to heal, they always came down to these 8. They always talked about these 8. And I was like, I've simplified in 20 years of practice. Everyone's complicating everything. I'm simplifying even more now than ever. And the body just craves simple, but done in this real consistent, savage way. So I took down these 8. And what I recommend people who anybody's listening, you write a paragraph or a description of what these 8 mean to you. And it's got to be intimate and specific to you, not to be judged by anybody else. And then you take each of those 8 and you split them into 2 categories, medicine and toxic. And I got this from Dr. Cassie Huckabee, the medicine and toxic. And you're going to rate your actions during the day. So the first one, a belief in something greater than yourself. Number 2, purpose. Number three, relationships. Number four, breath, meditation, prayer. Number five, natural light, number four is sleep. Number five, breath, meditation, prayer. Number six, outdoor light exposure, just outdoor exposure. Number seven, nourishment. Number eight, movement. So you go into each of those and you just see what they mean to you. Relationships, the ones that benefit, support your belief and your purpose, and the ones that challenge you to be better. And so you go into those columns and you look at those people who are medicinal in your life, who are medicine. You know, maybe it's family, maybe it's not. Maybe it's a loved one, lover, maybe it's not.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
You got to look that, and then you put it, who's toxic? And you try to literally take out what's toxic and either convert it to medicine or cut it out, totally cut it out. Mm-hmm. So you go through this whole list, and the list is listed linearly, but it's like quantum. It's all folded up on each other where they're all linked. You know what I mean? And then you just start to put your consciousness around what those mean to you. And every day, just little steps, take one toxic out, mm-hmm. add one medicine in, focus here, and celebrate. When you do something in that list, be sure to celebrate the small stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
That's something I really do for myself. I mean, I freak out when I find a penny. Like, dude, like it's money on the ground. Like, this is great. You know what I mean? I mean, it's like literally something small that needs to be celebrated. You start to focus on the fine stuff, you know, and you really get down to the level of a cat and you see the world under a plant, how it's this whole ecosystem. Like, oh my God. And all you did was kneel down to pet with a cat, which is a relationship one, right?
Yeah.
So it's like all of a sudden you start to piece all this together. You put your entire body into a healing state, which makes your life medicine. And then all of a sudden, the symptoms, which are really not sickness or disease at all, it's just the healing response, all of a sudden your body finishes healing. You're no longer aware of that process, and you just leveled up your life.
Yeah.
Whether you're 90 or 12 or married with kids or single or living in the Northern Hemisphere or Southern Hemisphere or student, it doesn't matter.
But now,
the way you look at those eight, it empowers people, puts it back into their hands. And that's scary for some, because with that responsibility comes that power, right? And with that power comes responsibility. And some people aren't ready for it.
Yeah.
Some people don't want it. And that's totally fine. You know, you have to understand that you're 110% accountable and responsible for your health expression. Like, nobody saves anybody. Nobody heals anybody. There is no healing force outside the body, period.
Yeah.
Like, it just doesn't work that way, you know? And so when you get into that state, that's when it's like, radical remission. It's like, no, that's just default. That's just how the body is,
right?
You know? And so everyone's like, do you take an inventory of the eight? I always have it in my head. And so everything I'm doing is either on that list, or if you ask me why I'm doing something, I'll always have a reason. There will never be because somebody told me to. Ever will I do
that. Same.
Or just, I don't know, it's Tuesday. I'm just doing it. Like, not ever will I just do something.
20 yeah.
seconds, five drops.
Living with purpose,
so
bro.
That's dude. It. Like, literally. Huh?
Living with purpose. Nothing.
That's it. Like, every step is a step with intention. And if it's not, because I used to do so much shit that didn't serve me, it was like you were supposed to, right? I'm just done. I'm done with that whole supposed to phrase. Like, my energy, my time, I've seen people transition on. I've seen people lose. Like, it's too valuable to me. This life is too amazing and valuable for me to spend it doing something that doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah.
And that's where I'm going. Like, everyone's like, how do you know what is going on in the current climate? How do you know what decisions to make? Because it doesn't make sense to me. Like, whatever my choices are going to make sense to how I live my life, because I've evaluated and worked so hard that things are just so clear now. And you said 2020. I made a video. 2020 is hands down best year of my life. Like, hands down.
Crazy.
I've leveled up immensely.
Yeah.
And I'm not hoping people perish.
No, you know what I mean? No.
I've improved. Like, what the
right.
hell? And the trauma response, our healing response is always greater than every trauma, or we never would have made it here.
Uh-huh.
So if we're wired for greater than any trauma we've ever experienced in our like gene pool, like, okay, what a great trauma. Thank you, idiots. Like, you just triggered a healing response in humanity that's greater than what you could post. Oh, delete me off Instagram. I will come back stronger. Thank you.
Yeah, bro. That's weights. That's your weights, bro. It's just like anything else, man. That's beautiful. Yeah. So like, I was just kind of giggling cause, I saw your video of you in the infrared, giving commands, dude. And then it made me think of how I thought that it was a 50-50 chance that you'd show up naked to the interview. So I was,
damn it. I know.
Or son in the bits, handle, dude. I've got
two clients in here right now and yeah, I'm sorry. I don't think they'd enjoy that too much.
Dude, it's
hilarious that those videos now and like the new name and everything's inspiring. They're just like, I'm getting naked in more ways than one. And that's truly what it is, right? It's like dropping all those personas that you were supposed to because society said you're valuable with this mask. Yeah. And not even the mask. I mean, like with what you've put on to be a good person.
Right, right.
Or an obedient person.
Right,
you know?
Right. Right. Or so, all the certificates, like you were saying, you know what I mean? I went to school. It. I did all this. I did this. And really, they mean dick, dude. I know people with... highly I want to say educated, right, through the I call it the indoctrination system. I do not believe we have an education system in this freaking whatever's going on,
right? I agree.
Yeah So anyway, I digress, man. Another question, how's your practice doing since this shit, which kind of rolls into it, right?
Yeah, so I never shut down. I stayed open. I've lost a lot of people, but then I've gained a lot of the right people. You know what I mean? And so what's crazy is there's people coming down from LA. There's people just wanting not only the help of the student I've become in what I do, but just to connect with people that are speaking the same language. Do you know what I mean? They're just in a place and the office is real open and friendly, and not everyone's on the same but it's accepting. Like everybody can have a different viewpoint and everybody can talk. Like I've got information all over the place, but not everybody has to agree with it.
Yeah.
So the practice is literally more right people, and it's trimmed off others that just didn't sync up. And so it's totally cool. But again, my purpose went beyond the office because we started the nonprofit with Alex Zek, and you said your purpose. Like my purpose is lasered in even greater to what I was doing before, which was, you know, help people, make enough money to serve your freedoms, and just be good. Well, okay, I can help more people now. Now I'm going to go, oh my God, now I've got this platform that I can speak and people are like all over the world wanting to hear or just see somebody living open, naked and free, right? And then we also have a nonprofit grassroots that we're, you know, kicking ass and trying to connect everyone globally. So it's all where it's supposed to be. You know what I mean? It's good.
Dude, I'm really loving your message, man. That's the big message we have here is just you are responsible for you. Everything, your whole existence, not just your health, bro. Like everything, that shitty thing that happened to you, you are responsible for it, believe it or not. And again, so that's kind of what we're doing right now is we've been connecting with the frontline nurses of America, of US, and the frontline nurses of Canada. Also, what is her name? Nicole, do you remember, girlfriend? She's that nurse that went from Utah to New York, and then she was on the New York Post. She was crying, saying, hey, they're murdering people. Her name's Nicole something. Anyway, she's like kind of now like the face of the frontline nurses. Point is, what we're trying to do is we're building counter economies. We're building counter everything. I'm not waiting for permission from the government.
No.
Who is my overlord or something? What the fuck is that? How did we all become such bitches? You know what I mean? And I'm sick of that shit, dude. I'm just no more. I've never asked for permission anyway. I'm not going to. But anyway, so that's what we're doing. 100% focus. So we're again. So I just went through a crazy thing with my daughter in a hospital. I haven't been in a hospital in many years, right? I grew up homeopathic. I'm all natural. Yeah. Always have, so just don't spend a lot of time in hospitals. So I didn't really realize how bad it's gotten. Anyway, if something happens, like another emergency situation, I'm not taking my daughter back to that type of environment, dude. It's scary, man. Right? That's some crazy shit, dude. Those people have zero conscience. It's, dude, they're mass zombies. They're fucking all mass zombies. I'm just, anyway, so that's what we're trying to do, man. We're just trying to create our own, right? And just like, okay, and it's coming faster than we thought, man. We're getting connections with people and like trauma surgeons and all these things. And also not just that, but the locations. Good. And there's a lot of people who are backing us on this, man. So anyway, to kind of roll into that, like if you were to build your own hospital, like a hospital, what would it look like to you?
Jesus, it'd be just the community. I mean, it would be an extension of the community. It wouldn't be this like special sick place. Like, no, what are you talking about? Like, the hospital is the community. You know, there's like one medicine man or one medicine woman that help, that know nature connected to you. They know it all. There's no segregation of systems.
Right.
There's no specialist in systems and nobody's talking to each other. Open air, plant medicine, herbs, like, sunshine used as medicine, like fresh air, grounding. I mean, you name it, movement, connection, like embracing, like not looking at anybody as sick or diseased, but this massive healing response that the whole community celebrates as an opportunity to heal, not this funky thing to hide and shy away from and something's wrong with you. So I would look at it as not even like a building. It's just like, It's just in the community.
Let me rephrase. What if you cut your leg off?
Oh, so then
that's what I mean, like a trauma hospital. Woman,
again, the medicine man or woman. So I've asked this people because I'm not going to give any credit to allopathic medicine. Zero.
Okay.
What about a gunshot? Zero. What about a car accident? Zero. They claim that they've got something over naturopaths. When I talk to a naturopath who doesn't have her head up her ass, she's like, no, I can go in. And you don't need antibiotics. You don't need insulin. You don't need any trauma, anything. Yeah. They can all be trained and do it. They just aren't allowed because they want that whole... Alex Zek's in the army. They taught him in 8 weeks how to suture bullet wounds and create like...
Oh, for sure. Without a doubt.
Like, this whole thing, like, well, I'm a medical doctor and I know how to insert a center line. Like, what? You don't have anything on anybody. So again, leg cut off. Because I asked this. If I get shot, because I want to know, because if something happened, because I always said, well, emergency room, though, for emergency care, they're great. And I started to second guess that, seeing, and you just confirmed it with your experience, right? So I'm like,
here's the thing. But so what happened is our daughter was born. So she was breech. So we were going to we had an out home water birth scheduled for here at the house, right?
Like, totally.
And then 5 weeks early, Emily here goes into labor. And so anyway, then the midwife's like, yo, you have to go to the emergency room. We go to the emergency room. They're like, okay, bro. So we have to do an emergency C-section. The baby was breech and had the umbilical cord wrapped around her neck 4 times. So, that sort of situation, how would I deal with that? Like, right. And this is what I'm talking about. So, and I think that you're going to get there with it. Literally, this is really why I wanted to speak to you most is about this, because I need more people like you but it's somebody that I trust in the space. Like my doctor, Dr. McJunkin, I've had him. He was my grandmother's doctor, right? He's an Eastern medicine. We grew up that way. Right. But there's not many more like that around, man. And that's why to me, you're a rock star and you're one of my heroes. I don't give a shit about any of those, but somebody who's going to stand up and has the balls to fucking actually say what's going on, dude, is one of the most rare things we have these days. So this is what I want to know. I mean, you know, and hopefully we can get more conversations, but
So my person who confirms intuitively, she confirms through practice. My doctor is Dr. Cassie Huckabee. She's the only naturopath I trust. Pretty much all others are bogus. The schools are just pumping them out. There is no doctor that you can try. I mean, it's so few and far between out of the millions. So when you ask her, because if I experience trauma, I'm going to her in her apartment. I don't care if my leg's cut off or if whatever. She knows how to cut open. She knows how to cauterize. She knows how to do all that. And on the extent of some of the more complicated stuff, they can learn. So there'd be this transition period where they could learn trauma care. It's not brain science. Like,
No. So they've just made it that way on purpose. And they've made it like legal. They make it like law. And they make all the words very hard to understand. And you're like, no, that's just the fucking head. Just your head, bro.
And then I was like, well, what about antibiotic? Like some of those, she's like, no, there's herbs for that. We can use that. What about type 1 diabetes? Because they hang insulin over you. No, we can do that. Like, they can't say that per se. You know what I mean? They can't say it now. But I'm saying, look, in this new earth, we're transitioning forward.
100%.
There's one doctor. There's one medical professional that has it all for the extreme. Other than that, like, it's not, and it's not naturopathic or allopathic. It's just medicine.
Right.
There's no more divisions.
Right.
There's
right.
no more like surgeon and no, there's right. the doctor.
Well, but that was created. Yeah. Right. And that was all created by the banksters, dude. And the, you know what I mean?
Exactly.
And, yeah. So
we want to get back to that. You know what I mean? So there's not even chiropractors. It's not acupuncturists. No, there's none of that. There's the one person that has access to it all and the putting it back on the human to be the, and even so the, for those real radical, radical moments, the one medicine man or woman knows
sure.
how
sure.
and is skilled. You know what I mean? So well, there'd be a transition would be pretty freaky because somebody's like, you know, my mother was in a car accident. They say that I think allopathic. I'm like, right now there are only few, but if we switch the training to the schools or the things that you guys are creating, like other systems, right?
Right.
The medicine man or woman would know how. So your car accident, we no longer even participate in any part of that system in any capacity. It's over. It's over.
Dude.
Or here's the thing too. Going, I was please. Thinking about this. I chose to ride in the car. I chose to go 84.
Yeah.
I chose to do, if I get in a gnarly accident and I go to my doctor and she's like, TJ, I can't, then I am going to choose to pass. Do you know what I mean?
At absolutely.
Peace. Like, so I'm okay with that. I don't know where other people are. Do you know what I mean? Like yeah. that's.
Yep. No, I'm there
I
with you.
To ride a car, I'm there. To do
yeah, dude. And again, so, that just goes up to, you know, radical ownership. And I wouldn't even call it radical. It's just ownership of your shit, dude.
10. That's what I agree. And so that's where I kind of was looking like, well, if there is this limit, but you know what? Then this is where I'm passing. This is my, you know, debt for riding. Like I could have walked or I could have chosen some other thing. And it's like, you know what? It's totally cool. Cause where I'm headed, it's pretty rad.
Yeah.
In my opinion.
Right. Right. Yeah, man. Awesome. Awesome. Well, shit, we still have some time here. Cool.
No, we're good. We're good. Hold on 1 second, bud.
Yeah. Do your thing.
Yeah. You want to hang? Mix in with her and then Cavs, biggity bam, done. All right,
cool. So I'm curious, like, so are you from Southern California?
I was born in Fullerton.
Okay.
Stayed here till first grade, and then we went East Coast, Florida, Minnesota, Indiana, the Carolinas, Georgia.
Oh, wow.
We're all over, and I haven't been back till 2015 when I moved back. So born in the States, like California let me go and was like, all right, but you'll be back.
Yeah. So
amazing.
California, and that's, I spent most of my adult life in California because I love it that much.
Yeah.
It's like, but I was in San Francisco and I was again software and I wanted to do my own startup and it was just way too expensive to live in San Francisco anymore.
Right.
I was just like, bro, it's whatever, not worth it. The juice wasn't worth the squeeze, so to speak. So how did you become what you're, did you have a father or an uncle or some sort of, you know, mentor or?
So that's a good question. So I was very observant. I think all children are observant, but I liked watching. I was fascinated by all things just natural. Like I loved being outside. I loved pets. I would observe just everybody's different reactions to everything, how everybody went at sports differently, how everybody ate their food differently, how everyone walked. Like I was just observing how everyone carried this uniqueness to them. And then I would model myself after the ones that I liked. And I started to follow that. And then I got into sports and then I got into some injuries and it was like, I started to look at and peel back the whole healing response from a soft tissue injury standpoint. Damn. So then back in like 2003, I retired from professional baseball and got into this training and rehab system where we were pulling the curtain back on soft tissue injury and the debacle of physical therapy. And you saw the same stuff going on that's going on now, only it was like from an orthopedic standpoint, it's like, wait, the whole system's just jacked. And this was early 2000s. Like it is literally perpetuating some of the worst outcomes in people. And this is just like limbs, you know, like, wait a second. And then my brother got into the psychiatric world and I got to train as psychiatrist. And so I got to see where he's coming from because there's no way you would get into that field if you had a, like, unless you were just completely hoodwinked. So like if you had just any kind of common sense, you wouldn't look at the body that way. And so the way he spoke about my brother, I'm like, this just doesn't, I got to see where you're coming from. Could I see your textbooks? So he gave me a couple of his textbooks because I wanted to learn. They're published by Pfizer.
Yeah, of course.
And I was like, wait a second. And this was like 2008. And I'm like, okay, I'm done. Like, I'm good. And so that's when I was really like, this whole thing is just a big sham in all realms. Not even, there is no form of medicine that's legit. And it's not for our benefit. So I'm out. And then I went back and got a chiropractic degree and put it all together. And it's kind of from a soft tissue injury standpoint. But again, like us having our physical bodies be in tune to be able to express our spiritual, intellectual, mental, and emotional, right? Like everyone's like, why do I train? Why do I do this? Like, have you ever cried? Did your abs hurt? Yeah, like a guttural cry. Mm-hmm. Like your physical self can express joy and sadness appropriately. And if we can express that, maybe we process it more healthfully.
Yeah.
Or I'm going to fall down, or my ability to fight an infection from my resiliency and my grit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, yeah, for sure.
There's those things that I'm kind of tying in together. And then the deeper dive shit, like crazy stuff that's just out of my scope, it's Dr. Cassie Huckabee, hands down. She's got people putting themselves in healing states from stuff that's incurable, right? That they've been told is incurable. And she's getting the fallout from people that have been cut, burned, shit just cut out. Just the way they treat the body and look at the body. It's as if it's something insane. To be controlled, manipulated. You were born, you know, defective.
And separate. Yeah. Yeah. It's completely cut off from any spirit, which is ironic because all the hospitals have like crosses on them and they're all named like some sort of Jesus shit or something, but there's not one God person in there. And you're like,
usually a church in the, I know. And it's the biggest disconnect from what human spirit actually is. So.
It's so odd. It's so odd. So baseball actually is kind of how, and just waking up from that and you were like, whoa, what? Yeah. And busted you out. And then you started pursuing this, dude. That's awesome. I love that. Cause that means more than anything. And I, like I said, I just really like your current message of getting naked. You know what I mean? And
and
taking that self responsibility. And I also noticed that you're pretty esoteric in the sense that, you know what I mean? You talk about some ego and all that good stuff, which I'm very interested in, you know, I'm Eckhart Tolle kind of stuff like that, man. Been a big fan of his for a long time. So question about ego, what would you say the role of ego is in trauma?
In trauma?
Yeah.
Oh gosh.
I guess, right. Like they say, it's like past childhood trauma, right? And all this stuff. But I mean, and it's kind of like, I mean, is ego trauma? Is trauma ego? Or are they?
I don't know, right? Like, I don't know where that fits. I just know, and that's the thing. I don't, one, our, as far as we know, people did the best they could with whatever. You know, and what I won't say is like a victim of anything from 0 to 9 years old. Like our body's ability to adapt, we could do. Now, even like some of the gnarliest stuff, but you're still here, right? Like somebody's like, but you're still alive? Then you can adapt for sure. Yeah. And I just, even if it's, you know, we had some pretty horrible stories and everyone's got stories and some more horrific than others, right?
Sure.
But when I'm sitting here, I'm like, okay, wow. I went through that. I went through that. I experienced that. I perceived that. Now it's on me to use it as an opportunity, as a lesson, as a guide, because there is no diseased feeling. There is no bad part of me. There's no flawed part of me ever. Is there a flawed?
Thank you, bro. Thank you. Thank you. No. Fuck that dogma shit, dude. I'm so tired of that stuff too.
Like, I know.
Trying to drill into you that you suck or somehow you're wrong and you just for existing, like you were saying. It's just, that's kind of the narrative.
Yeah. I can't, you know, and I just think we're too, nature doesn't make mistakes and neither does our body, and the communication with the forces outside of us, to in us, to on us, to, we're so linked up like one big, huge organism, right? I fail to see that there's flaw in that. It's too beautiful. I've seen too many things that are just too amazing. Yeah. Look at a friggin' sunset and think we're flawed in some way.
You know I know, I mean? Right, man? Yeah. Like, so now that we're here, I mean, you know, we're not monetizing our podcast or anything like that. So fuck them. I don't give a shit. I want to talk about the vaccine. What do you think, man? I want to talk about this experimental mRNA injection.
Yeah. Not a vaccine, right?
Whatever. I have a big problem with all vaccines in general, but specifically, like, what's going on right now with this whole, like, what's going on, dude? This whole push.
That's the thing. I don't, with the way I live my life and the way I've, what I've been through and who I, you know, connect myself with, whatever they're rolling out doesn't make sense to me. And so when I say, I can't, because everyone's like, I know the information on it. I know mRNA. You don't know shit. Yeah, no, you only know the stuff they gave you.
Right.
Admit that you don't know dick.
Yeah.
Stop acting like you're an expert in really bad things. So this whole, like, I know.
Yeah.
You know what they gave you.
Yeah.
Stop.
Yeah.
So what I do know is that that mode makes no sense to me. It just doesn't register on my brain. So when people are like, are you getting it? I'm like, absolutely not. Why? It doesn't make sense to me. And then that's it. Why do I have to explain anything further? But then when I say something like, I will die before getting this, they're like, are you serious?
Yes. Yes.
Because if we allow anything to pierce our skin against our will, it's over. It's over. There's
Dude, people have already taken away the right to breathe clean air, Tommy, and given it away.
It's over.
They've given it, dude. I mean, to me, that's where we are. That's what made me, dude. I was like, what? People are actually going to do this? People are actually going to say, okay, I'm going to put this over my face.
Right.
No, dude.
So that's the line, right? Like, that's the thing for me. I mean, the line was a long time ago, but like, so I don't know like what it is. The industry doesn't make any sense to me because it's so corrupt. Yep. I don't think viruses ever been isolated or showed to cause disease from people way smarter than me proving that. So it's like, it's just my life and that's how I live and it doesn't make sense. And I'm not going to get on somebody for living it differently, right? Like you go choose your thing. I'll choose my thing. I like where I'm at. I'm not hurting you. I'm actually helping you by being my best self. And that's it. So as far as where we're headed, I've stopped doing the research on the details because I don't trust the source. Like everything is all controlled information. I'm like, wait, this isn't even... Yeah. I'd rather watch an 80s movie than read any article on this vaccine or whatever you want to call it. Emergency use authorization medical experiment, you know,
I'm good.
I'm going to be, and I say this, everyone's like, have you seen the latest on Bill Gates or have you seen? And I joke because I'm like, no, I'm too busy sunning my balls. Like literally that's
way more important, dude. Absolutely, dude. Infinitely more important than worrying about Bill Gates.
That's it. You know, I've got other things to do. And that truly, how do you, because I'll get people, how do you stay so positive? I am honestly so obsessed with living this unreal life. There's no room for the other stuff. Like, I don't even have space to hold it in. And so, that's kind of where I'm at.
Yes, dude. You know, no energy for all that shit, right? 100% focused on what we want, not what we don't want. It's fine. We know it's there, but we're focused here. So last question, I'll let you go. I know you're coming up, but
hit me.
What do you know about common law and correcting your status? You ever heard of anything like that?
No. My buddy was talking about it and you tell me. I didn't know anything about it. It just came up in my horizon like 2 weeks ago and that's all I know is my buddy was talking about it.
Got you. Well, I mean, that's another thing that I'm really trying to help kind of push is that education on what that is. Me and my family, we're all corrected, which means that we are no longer under the rule of the slavery. So it's crazy, crazy. But when you're born, basically what happens is you give ownership of your child or you were given ownership to the state. And then at which they give you a receipt or they give your parents a receipt, which is known as your birth certificate. Now what you are collateral for the rest of your life to the bank. That is what you are. And that's how every time we go to war, we have to borrow bank from the Federal Reserve Bank, a centrally owned bank at interest. Right. And I can go on and on. This is what really I do. When I was in the Marines, this all blew my skull off, Tommy. I was just, dude. Anyway, dude, I know you got more. We'll let you go. Thank you so much, dude.
No. I want to know real quick because my buddy said, like, what's the process of paperwork? Like, how do you get?
I'll send you links, dude. If you want, okay. Actually, you know what? I just, on Sunday, we just interviewed the Maricopa County recorder, the woman who recorded us, who got us brought back to the land. We just did an interview with her on Sunday. I'll send you that
I
got links, dude.
My buddy brought up the same thing. He talked to somebody who went through the steps and made himself this free And I'm like, why would the government allow that though? You know what I mean? Like,
they don't have a choice. They don't have a choice. All you're doing is, so what happened is you unknowingly and unwillingly got into a contract, right? All law, the common law of man, the God's law is contract. It's based on a very simple contract of two willing and knowing participants in that contract. Oh, wow. When you were born into that, you were not a willing participant. So all you have to do is you just correct your status and you bring your status back to the land. But dude, I'll send you links. I have links.
I got questions. Dude, we got to do this again because I got questions.
Please. Yeah. Please, please.
As like a business owner and as a...
I know. Like, I have multiple businesses, dude.
Okay.
Multiple.
All right. Well, we got to get into it again then.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, man.
All right. Thanks, brother. I appreciate you, dude.
You guys are rad. Thank you so much.
Thank you, man. Cheers. All right. Later.
Be good, guys. See ya.
Later.